Hi there, my name is Chris, and welcome back to my sewing channel called Sew Notes. So this is Sunday, so this is a Fit Check Sunday episode, and to be honest, I don't have much to report on because I'm very conflicted. I thought with my last episode I was okay with the fit, and I know that I need to do a sway back adjustment. I know that. A part of me wants to do it because I want to give it my best shot. But the other part of me is scared. I watched a video on how to do a sway back adjustment. I did a sway back adjustment a few years ago working on a pattern test, and the designer told me that I needed to do a sway back adjustment, and she sent me a link, and it was her own link on her own blog, and I followed her instructions and it worked out perfect. But then I started looking at different sway back adjustments on the computer, and this one video kind of just scared me a little bit about it, because I remember doing my sway back adjustment is I just took a wedge out of the center back seam, and that was all, just a wedge, and that was all, and it corrected it. But this other video that I was watching, it said that you need to take the wedge out of the center back, but then you need to straighten out that back seam line, and then because when you straighten out that back seam line, you're going to have extra fabric at the back seam line, so you'll have to take it out from the side seam, and then you had to square off your top and bottom, and it just really stressed me out because I feel like that particular method of doing the sway back adjustment was very, I don't know what the word is I'm looking for, but it was like four steps. So let's say you made a mistake on step two, it would throw off step three and four, and that really stresses me out. I just wanted one process of maybe taking out the wedge and trying that. And so that's why I'm here, and I'm just very conflicted because come June, I really wanted to start sewing. So now in my mind, I have to start sewing. Come July, like, I need to get sewing. Are you able to help me out and give me some guidance? Because I am just stressed out about this. This is supposed to be a fun learning experience, and this sway back, it's haunting me. My heart is telling me, do the sway back. Do your best, Chris, and do the sway back adjustment. But my mind's saying, no, I don't want no more headaches because I don't want to. I guess what I'm trying to say is I made a mistake on that small bust adjustment, and I took out too much, and it just trickled down to, I just did unnecessary adjustments if I would have done that one properly the first time. And now seeing this video and seeing that you have to take the wedge out, you have to square up your corners, take stuff out of the side seam, that really stressed me out. And if I make a mistake somewhere, it's just going to set me back, I think. So I think right now is I'm going to just take that wedge out, and that's it. I'm going to try to take that wedge out and see what happens. And if more happens and I need to do more and just more adjustments, I might just go back to this one that I have. I think that's the plan, because I'm running out of time and fabric is hard to find. So this is the pattern again we're working with, is Vogue 8943. And going into this, I thought I was going to do it. And then as I was doing all the fitting, I had decided that Pink Triangle Makes, she made this for the mother of the bride dress, and she made hers with satin and a lace overlay, so she didn't need a slip. So if, as you could tell, this dress is like see-through and it requires a slip. And after seeing Pink Triangle Makes make it with a satin and a lace overlay, I was leaning towards that option too, because I really essentially want to skip sizing the slip. I don't want to try to fit a slip now. So then I went on Friday and I looked at my local fabric store at their bridal special occasion fabrics, and they didn't have what I was looking for. So then I contacted a fabric store in Vancouver, and let me tell you, they were so great. I emailed them and I said, I'm working on this dress pattern. It's for an anniversary, and these are the fabrics that I was thinking of pairing together. I would like to see pictures, if possible, of what the fabrics look like. So essentially it was a satin with a lace overlay. And so my wedding colors were fuchsia and silver. And in fact, I could show you what my centerpiece looks like because it's right beside my bed. So this here was my centerpiece. So my husband and I found these wooden roses. They're wooden. They were clearing them out and we were walking the mall and we saw them clearing them out and we said, yeah, that's perfect for our wedding. So there was fuchsia and like white with fuchsia. And then I bought this trim. This trim was actually hard to get. I think I got this off Etsy back in the day, but now you can get it at the dollar store. And then a fuchsia ribbon and more, and then just clear beads. So this was one of our centerpieces. The other one was a square vase, and I have that downstairs that I could show you later. But so I could show you pictures right now. So Dress So is the fabric store in Vancouver, and they kindly took pictures of what the fuchsia lace looked over diamond white satin, pewter satin, and a gray satin. And they told me that one of the satins that I picked out, they thought that it would be too thick for the dress. So I'm leaning towards the two. So I was then thinking maybe I should just do fuchsia on fuchsia. And that's where I'm conflicted now too. Do I do the diamond white? Do I do the gray? Do I do fuchsia on fuchsia? This is just such a special project to me. I want it to be perfect. I don't want to be disappointed at all. And I think that's why I'm putting so much pressure on myself right now. And I'm feeling the pressure and I've kind of stepped back from it. And stepping back, it's not giving me clarity. It's actually stressing me out now because I'm running out of time. So I just wanted to give you this update. I know I said don't let fear get to you, and right now the fear is getting to me. And I'm just being honest with my journey and I'm trying not to let the fear get to me. So feedback in the comments would be greatly appreciated. I hope by next Sunday I have my mind made up. I hope that I have my fabric ordered because I'm going to order it online because I can't find it in person here. Also, I need to think about how to finish that neckline. I have to look at the instructions and figure out how to finish that neckline because I believe the neckline is finished with a lace. And I do recall from my friend Michelle sewing this dress, I do recall her using a special lace at that neckline. So If I'm just going to be doing the satin and the lace, I might need to figure out how to finish that neckline. So I have my research cut out for me. I have some soul searching to do on whether to do that sway back, or I think the plan now is just do that wedge and see where it takes me. And if I'm not happy with the wedge, I might just go back to this last toile that I had. Thank you for listening to my rant. Thank you for listening to my struggles. I'm just being really honest and real here. And the fear is getting to me now. But the fear is also causing stress because I want to get this done. This is a goal. It's always been a goal of mine to sew a fancy dress. And I didn't, what better opportunity now for my 10th wedding anniversary to sew a fancy dress, because my goal in my mind was my kids' graduation and wedding. So that's a long ways away. Here's practice number one. So thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for listening. And any tips or suggestions that you might have, please leave them in the comments. I love hearing from you. And just thank you so much.